Everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. The question for today is distribute candies. So we have given a problem statement in which they have referred to Alice that she has n candies and where the ith candy is type of candy type I. Alright, so she noticed that she started to gain weight and so she visited a doctor. The doctor advised her only to eat n by 2 candies she has. And it's given that n is always even. So we don't have to think about the case where n is odd. So it's given in the question that n is always even. So she takes the candies very much and she wants to eat the maximum number of different types of candies while still following the doctor's advice. So two things we have. So the doctor advised her to take n by 2 candies and also she wants to eat unique number of candies. Alright. So these two things we'll keep in mind. And so given an integer array of candy type of length n, we have to return the maximum number of different types of candies she can eat if she only eats n by 2 of them. So we have to return the maximum number of different types of candies. Alright. So basically we have to look for the unique candies and the constraint given to us is that she only eats n by 2 of them. So this is the question that is given to us and let's see for the constraints that are given to us. So n is given as candy type length and n ranges from 2 to 10 to power 4. N is always even and the values ranges from minus 10 to power 5 to 10 to power 5. Alright, these are the constraints that are given to us. Now let's see the approach for this question. So before discussing the solution approach for this question, let's see some examples. So one example given to us are this, that, and there are the candies. And what we'll doing is we want unique candies. So one is occurring two times, two is occurring also two times, and three is also occurring two times. So unique candies we have is three. So three unique candies and the total length is six. So it's advised to her by doctor that she can eat only n by 2 candies. So n by 2 is 3. So 3 unique and 3. So the maximum number that we can return here is 3. Alright. Let's see in this case. In this case we have candy with number 6 and that is occurring 4 times. So n by 2 is 4 by 2 is 2. But in this case we will only return 1. Because either we have to return the unique candies or we have to return the n by 2 value. So minimum of both. I think the example is clear. So what we have to do is first we will take anything like a hash map or hash set so that we cannot store the duplicate values. We want only the unique values and we will store them in a hash set. Alright, and after that we will just compare. So first we will take an hash set and store all the values that we have by traversing the array. This will take O of n time as well as O of n running time and as well as O of n space complexity in worst case in which we have all the unique values in array. And after that we'll do nothing, we'll just return the minimum of the both, minimum of either n by 2, that is the length by 2, or we will return the length of this hash set. So that will be our final answer. I hope this approach is clear and let's see the code for this. So here is the code. First we have taken a hash set and we have added all the values in the hash set. As we know, it cannot contain duplicate values, so it will be automatically added. And we have traversed this array with for each loop. And after that, we have just returned the minimum of both of the two, either the size or the length by 2, n by 2. Alright, now let's submit it. So it's done. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like this video, share it among your friends, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you everyone. Bye-bye.